No, I'm not blaming you. Believe me. But, number two there came in. Alex. Is he your change of pace kind of back? Or,
yeah, so it's.
The first guy wasn't.
It's Marcus and Alex. Marcus got a little banged up tonight. We switch back and forth anyway. Usually Marcus starts, see how Marcus is going. Then we put, Wicks in. And whoever got the hot foot is who we run with. Mm-hmm. Back and forth. And tonight it was Wicks.
Thank you.
He is fast.
He is fast.
Wow.
He got caught down here the one time. On the first one, he got caught. On the one.
Yeah, he did.
Oh, no, he almost got caught.
He got caught.
I was like, I don't get caught. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it was good stuff.
Is that more... Is he on a pitch count or anything? He had a lot of carries. Do you have his stats for him?
We got Wicks. We got him 29 rushes for 233 yards. 2 touchdowns.
29 for what?
233. 2 touchdowns.
That's a pretty good number.
It's not bad. I'll take it.
Is that typical for him?
He had 109 last week.
But I mean, number of rush carries, because he's not a big kid.
Well, usually him and Marcus split.
Right.
So that's a lot of carries for him tonight.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. That's probably the first time he's carried that much. Since he's been on varsity.
What does this win mean for you, other than it's homecoming and all that kind of good stuff? But does this put you in the championship game?
No, I don't even know. I know we got two more games to go. We got Pilates coming up. Pilates is very good. That's going to be a battle. That's next week.
Okay.
And then we got to play the boys from Severn from up the road, and that's going to be a battle.
That's awesome.
So, we're just focused on winning the next game, and whatever happens after that happens. And tonight is, for me, this is the first time I've ever beaten Boys Latin on the varsity level.
Really?
So this was nice, finally. Yeah, we've been close a couple times, but they've always had our number. So for us to pull it out tonight was nice.
What was different about tonight than your other games against us?
I think this team is a tough team. We came into the season, a lot of young guys, placed a lot of starters, and they're just a tough, gritty team. They work hard, and they don't quit. We've been down twice now. That's the third time being down at halftime. And it's the third time we come back to win a game. So they don't quit. They keep working. They keep fighting. And it's good things are happening for us.
Were you thinking about not going for the field goal there in OT?
Because
you were pretty close.
I was close. We were close, but they were doing a good job of blowing us up. And I said, let's put the pressure on them. Let's get the three and let's see what happens.
And you guys put some pressure on their kicker there at the end, right?
Yeah.
Look at me. Do you know who that was?
Off the corner was Dane Blair.
Now, last year when I was here, Dane Blair was the man. He's still the man.
He's run back two kicks so far this year.
Okay.
And he's playing a lot of defense for us. He's our starting corner, starting slot, so he's on the field a lot. He's doing a great job.
But he doesn't run the ball from scrimmage much.
Not often. But, we might change up a little bit next week. But, yeah, he's playing so much on offense and defense. We try to limit the carries on offense from behind him.
What did BL do tonight that kind of threw you guys off?
Nothing. We knew coming. BL's always a very well-coached team. Last year we went up there. We expected really to beat them last year, and they kind of punched us in the mouth and suckered us. So this year we were prepared for them, and they pretty much ran what we thought they were going to run. They loaded the box on us, and we just nickel and dime them until we broke something.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.